Screens, the limiting factor in your life. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh. Welcome back to Control Your Brain, how you can control your brain in 5 minutes a week so that you can reach your full potential. Today, we're going to talk about screen time and how it's a limiting factor. So what we're going to do today is I'm going to present the idea of screen time as a limiting factor and why. Then number two, we're going to talk about how screens impact your brain performance pattern. Number three, I'm going to give you a Gestalt exercise so that you can connect your mind and your body so that you can help rewire your brain in the right direction. And lastly, your journal activity for the day so you can reflect upon how you can move forward towards your authentic self. So let's dig in. Number one, the idea for today is screen time as a limiting factor. Now, without going into real depth of detail, what I want you to know in this episode is that screen time is limiting your brain's performance pattern and its ability to operate at its full functioning, its full health, its peak performance, full potential. This is true. And the reason being is, first of all, screens are a supernormal stimulus. They're giving your brain an excessive amount of dopamine, especially if you're engaging in seeking and scrolling, fast trolling through content like you would on social media, or even choosing a video to watch. So that is a dopamine seeking activity. Dopamine is the molecule of motivation, more, and pleasure. And when you seek and never find, it puts you in an insatiable looking for the best thing to give you the most pleasure. But ultimately, that turns on you and you end up in a dopamine deficit state, lacking pleasure in your life. And many people report this feeling to me that when they start scrolling, they feel good and it feels relaxing. But after just a little while, it ramps up their anxiety. They'll have fear of missing out. And ultimately, in the end, they don't feel very well. That's because of brain mechanisms at play. You're getting a lot of dopamine, and then your brain wants more of it, and it has to get higher level stimulation to be able to feel as good as it did at the beginning. It becomes a downward spiral. This is true for gaming. This is true for social media. This is true for just watching passive content videos that show up in front of you. We have to be careful and be very intentional on moderating our screen time in today's day and age. Now, another reason is because it changes your brain performance pattern, not only from a dopamine standpoint, but from an electrical energy standpoint. It makes your brain use what I call a wired and tired pattern. That's because it is so stimulating, it wires your brain, and then eventually it tires your brain. And now you're using the stressed out, fatigued, and overwhelmed brain pattern that's out in the extremes of very fast electrical energy and very slow electrical energy. I call it the pendulum effect brain or strained brain. You're using energy in the extremes of fast and slow, not in the middle of calm focus. So if you stay away from screen time, it's so much easier for your brain to use that functional regulated pattern that helps you feel calm and focused and amazing, do your best work, be the happiest version of yourself with your people, and enjoy your hobbies. But when you're out in the extremes, you become aggravated and irritable, you become anxious, you become depressed, you become unmotivated because your brain is out in the extremes. So that's the cautionary tale and the idea for the day. So what do you do about it? Let's go to number three, which is your Gestalt exercise for the day, connecting your mind and your body. So here's what I would like you to do. Get outside and do some grounding activities. Grounding is something that has been known for a long time. The earth and trees resonate at the calm focus energy. It's called Schumann's resonance. So when you go outside in nature, your brain is coming in towards the optimized pattern from those extremes. It's a really powerful way that you can offset screen time in the short run, and especially if you start being in nature more, you will start tipping the balance of using the extreme pattern, pendulum effect, strain brain, and you will start using the optimized pattern more. Now, there's a very large study on optimal productivity that talks about taking breaks every hour and 15 minutes. This is how I simplify the study. So for optimal productivity, every hour and 15 minutes, walk away from your screens, and on your break, do not spend time on a screen. Spend time outside, just go outside for 15 minutes. And I mean, you can literally go out for 3 minutes and you will get a very minor brain reset. If you want a more major brain reset, go outside for 15 minutes. Your brain will come in from the extremes and you will be reset so that that trajectory no longer is stunted or limited. Now, the potential of using your brain across the day increases. That's what I want for you. So your Gestalt exercise for the day, get your mind, body, and brain connected by getting outside for short breaks every hour and 15 minutes. Now I hear you. I hear you saying, I can't go outside every hour and 15 minutes. Figure out when you can. If it's every 2 hours, do it, even for 5 minutes. If it's every 3 hours, do it, even for 5 minutes. Because it will be a game changer of how your brain can express itself over the day. Okay, now, moving on to number 4, which is your brain hack strategy for the day. Now that you know how to offset screen time, this is what I want you to consider. When you're scrolling and when you're on social media, yes, it's fun for a little while, but figure out how you're gonna stop yourself after 15 minutes. 15 to 30 minutes, 15 minutes of passively just watching what shows up in front of you, 30 minutes if you're actually engaging in watching a show. You know, most shows are 30 to 45 minutes. It has story structured as a beginning, a middle, and an end. Stay within that range. If you're scrolling, keep it at 15 minutes or your brain's gonna tank from wired to tired and you're not gonna feel good. So this is the journal reflection. Figure out how you're gonna balance your schedule across your days and across your week. So there's more actual time in your life getting dopamine from your relationships, your work, and your hobbies. Less time on a screen getting excessive dopamine from passively consuming content. And then we're talking here about your full peak potential, the life you've always wanted to live. On paper, write that out. What is it? What is it you've always wanted to do? What does your full potential look like? Because most people are passively consuming whatever shows up in front of them because they're not on purpose. When you get on purpose, it brings your brain back to that optimal mode. Purpose is the solution for everything. So figure it out. What does that authentic life look like? What is it that you want to do? Write it down and then figure out your first action step to move toward it. All right, I hope that helps you out. And as always, control your brain or it'll control you.